Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy Dentistry. Today we are uploading a very important syndrome, that is the Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome, which is also called as cheilitis granulomatosa or orofacial granulomatosis. First of all, I would like to thank each one of you for the constant support, love and trust you have shown in us. It inspires me to upload more lectures on our channel. Please friends, if you have not yet done, please subscribe to our channel. Also do comment and let us know your feedback. Share these lectures with all your friends and share knowledge. And if you like the lecture, please click on the thumbs up icon. In the new year 2020, we would definitely work out to meet with your expectations. We would like to increase your knowledge with uploading more lectures, and we will also try to have some interactive sessions with you all. So stay tuned to our channel. Let's begin today's lecture on Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome. In this lecture, we will be studying what is Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome, the etiology of it, clinical features, differential diagnosis, histopathology, and the treatment part of Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome. Now, cheilitis granulomatosa is the granulomatous inflammation of the lips. What is the term mesocheilitis? Mesocheilitis is the granulomatous inflammation confined to the lips. Mesocheilitis is also known as a monosymptomatic form of Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome. Now, the Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome is made up of triad of features. This triad include cheilitis granulomatosa, facial palsy, and fissured tongue. So, in this picture number one, you can see cheilitis granulomatosa. In picture number 2, you can see that this patient is suffering from facial palsy and show the features of facial palsy such as flattening of the wrinkles of the forehead, widening of the opening between the eyes, flattening of the fold of the lip, and drooling of the corner of the mouth. And the third feature is the fissured tongue. Now, the etiology of Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome, there is a genetic predisposition to the syndrome, and the other factors than the genetic predisposition are the dietary factors and the contact antigens. The clinical features, the course of the disease is episodic, the symptoms appear in early childhood period, and there is no gender predilection. The upper lip is more involved than the lower lip. The earliest manifestation of the Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome is the appearance of a sudden diffuse nodular swelling of the lip or face involving the upper lip, lower lip, cheeks, forehead, eyelids, and one side of the scalp. Now, this is the pictorial representation of the early manifestation, where you can see a diffuse swelling involving the lower lip. Now, this nodular swelling undergoes cracking, fissuring, and reddish brown discoloration appears, and also scales are formed on the surface of the swelling, which leads to pain in the swelling and rubbery consistency to the swelling. So, this is the progress diagrammatic representation of the cheilitis granulomatosa of the lips, in which you can see cracks, fissures, scales on the lips. Second feature of the Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome is the fissured tongue, which is present in 20-40% of the population. There is also a genetic susceptibility to fissured tongue. There is loss of taste from the tongue, and there is decrease in the salivary gland secretion. Then the facial palsy is reported in 30% of the patient, and the lower motor neuron type of facial palsy is reported, which may be intermittent or permanent, unilateral or bilateral, and partial or complete. The other nerves which are involved are olfactory, auditory, glossopharyngeal, and hypoglossal nerve. The differential diagnosis may be due to insect bites or sarcoidosis. The histopathology of the lesion show three features: chronic inflammatory cell infiltrate in the lesion, perivascular cell aggregation. Cells such as lymphocytes, mast cells may aggregate around the blood vessels. And thirdly, a non-caseating granuloma may be formed, which includes the epithelioid cells and the Langhans giant cell. So, under microscope, you can see a chronic inflammatory cell infiltrate. Then, around the blood vessels, the some cells may aggregate, and there is a non-caseating granuloma formation. Then the treatment of Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome. First, if any allergen is identified, complete abstinence of the allergen is advised. Then the intralesional injectable steroids, NSAIDs, mast cell stabilizers, clofazimine and tetracycline may be given to the patient. In advanced cases, surgery and radiation may be advised. So here we complete with the discussion on Melkersen-Rosenthal syndrome. Hope you understood the lecture. That's all for now. Happy study.